So this article I found on BuzzFeed was about a writer, which I've got it here on screen, who lost her book deal after calling out a DC Metro worker for eating on the train, right? So a really innocuous kind of, you know, thing that happened on social. I remember seeing over the weekend or a couple of weekends ago. So essentially I see this tweet go out. This lady's kind of bemoaning the fact that her trains are late, and then she's kind of commenting that, you know, somebody that works for the Metro line is eating. And I've got a tweet here, actually, right? Literally the entire story from BuzzFeed. So Natasha Tynes, who said she got death threats and was forced to leave the US and had suicidal ideations in the viral aftermath of her tweet, right? And this is, again, coming. I implore you to read John Ronson, So You've Been Publicly Shamed. It'll really change your perspective about this kind of lynch mob culture, counterculture we've got going on, because I really think it's getting to a point now where it's getting a bit scary. We saw it already with the lady that was speaking over Beyonce to Jay-Z during the NBA finals. It's getting a bit too crazy now. It's getting to a point where if someone dies, no one's going to take responsibility for it. The trolls, the people that are going after people and trying to counsel them, won't think it's their fault. They'll just think the person was overreacting. It's a very dangerous ground that we're on at the moment. So this lady called Natasha Tynes is a writer, happens to be, I don't know if it's like Saudi Arabia or American flag, I'm not sure what that is, somewhere in the Middle East. She tweeted the following: when you're on your morning commute and see a WMAT employee in uniform eating on the train, I thought we were not allowed to eat on the train. This is unacceptable. Hope the train responds. When I asked the employee about this, her response was, worry about yourself. Unsuck the DSC Metro, right? So that's what she tweeted, right? Blah, blah. And then you see the worker there eating her food. Now, the thing that's really funny about this whole situation, right? And then again, so that whole thing happens, the tweet goes out and the whole internet goes crazy. They start saying that she's work shaming. She doesn't know the story of that lady, why she needs to eat, what's her business, privilege, all this stuff. Even though this lady is Middle Eastern, thank God she's Middle Eastern. If she was white, I think her life would have been completely ruined. But she's Middle Eastern, so again, they're just, you know, going on and on about that. And then then what transpired is that the lady that tweeted it, Natasha Tynes, is a writer, a well-known writer, and then she had a book deal with a publishing company called Rare Bird. And as soon as the backlash happened, some snitches and some snakes in that whole cancel culture world went out and contacted the publisher and got them to kind of review their, you know, agreement with this writer and say, hey, how can you represent her when she's saying these things about these train workers? So the publisher, Rare Bird, tweeted out the following: a word from us on what happened this morning with Natasha Tynes in DC. And they made a tweet and then attached the note and said, Rare Bird is aware that an author distributed by us, Natasha Tynes, and published by an imprint that is subsidized by us, California, Cold Blood, did something truly horrible today in tweeting a picture of a Metro worker eating her breakfast on the train this morning and drawing attention to her employer. Black women face a constant barrage of this kind of inappropriate behavior directed toward them and constant policing of their bodies. That is really not true, right? If there's one person you're not going to approach in public and take a picture of unless you think you have a reason to, is a black woman, right? Because you know you're going to get knocked the fuck out. That isn't true. I don't think people do that at all. You have to be very wary of taking pictures or videos of a black lady working, especially for any sort of public sector job. We think this is unacceptable and have no desire to be involved with anyone who thinks it's acceptable and jeopardize a person's duty. So essentially they dropped her. So she goes from tweeting a picture of somebody working on a train, eating on a train, and then complaining that her trains are always late or whatever it may be, you know, bemoaning the lack of service. And then it goes from that all of a sudden to her losing her book deal, to her moving out of the country, having suicidal thoughts, all that malarkey. Absolute crazy nonsense story, right? But what makes it interesting is the background behind it, right? Because what you end up happening, so after the whole, you know, foray of the outrages kind of stemmed and everyone's kind of got over it, the other side of the story that's more interesting is that in DC, in Washington, those trains are well known for being highly policed, right? They have police officers on the platform, police officers out the side of the station. They have wardens inside the station who police and make sure no one eats on the platform or on the train, sorry. There's been numerous videos I've seen online of people arguing with certain people, telling them to put their food away because it gets really highly policed. They're really finicky about people eating on the train. It's a thing, right? So much so that people get fined. On the spot fine if they do eat on a train. So what the lady was doing was just bringing to light that the hypocrisy of this train station or this train services saying that the commuters can't eat, but then their own staff eating on the train quite brazenly, not even in a kind of sly way, just sitting there eating their breakfast, which is a fairly fair argument to kind of raise. So it kind of put it into context. Again, it wasn't a racial thing. It wasn't specifically targeted at the woman because she was black. It didn't matter. Just whatever. Just it was about her uniform, what she represented, not about her as a race. It wasn't about shaming her for the job that she had. It was basically complaining that as commuters, we get treated one way for breaking the rules, and your people who are meant to enforce these rules are breaking them themselves. What kind of example does that set? You have to set some kind of example, right? But the social media was like, no, they don't. She can do what she wants. She works there. It's your, mind your damn business. Well, now the story gets interesting, because this Natasha Times had enough of the public outrage and was appalled that her publishing company would drop her. So then she decides to file a $13 million lawsuit against her book publisher. That's when you know cancel culture has gone too far. Because what you see with this story is a book publisher trying to do the right thing, caving into social pressure, thinking that what they've seen on first glance is the story, when really the story is that in DC, they fine you if you eat on a train. So if a commuter sees someone that works for the trains eating on a train, they have a reason to complain. In the same vein, if you remember the other story in Chipotle of the lady getting accused of denying services and black teens because they record her as she's denying them service and saying that they have to pay first, right? She gets fired, and then the story kind of comes out that, oh no, actually those black teens have go around and terrorize local Chipotles, order wraps and whatever, maybe burritos, and then run off without paying. So she was aware of who they were and was telling them, hey, you've come in here a few times, I'm not gonna let you steal anymore. If you want to buy a burrito, you can, but you have to pay first. And then they offer her back a job. She says no thanks and moves away. But imagine the kind of terror, imagine the kind of anguish you've caused that person in that period of time. They're being accused of, you know, being a racist or whatever it may be, like just the most abhorrent things ever. They're being targeted by people. And these are all general, these are all everyday people. Fair enough, for the writer, maybe different, she might have a more of a bigger following. But imagine just being like a regular person, working in your own little niche. And then suddenly you've got the whole world around you telling you that you're a horrible person. So now Natasha Tynes is suing her publisher for $30 million for, I'm assuming, for loss of potential earnings. Really, really crazy story. So that's a picture of her. This is here. A Jordanian-American author, Natasha Tynes, is suing book publisher Rare Bird for more than $30 million in damages, alleging the company defamed her and breached a publishing contract amid a racial social shaming scandal in May. The incident left Tynes essentially stripped of a book deal, placed on leave from her job, and hospitalized for major conditions. Jesus Christ, including suicidal thoughts, a lawsuit filed in the week of the Supreme California County Court. Jesus Christ. So she had a regular job as well. Mamma mia. A Sunday statement from David S. Elson, attorney representing Rare Bird Books, called Tynes' lawsuit baseless and pledged to fight the allegation. Counsel for Rare Bird's book and Tynes provided conflicting reports of Tynes' publishing contract. Tynes made national and international headlines in May and was widely accused of racism as she tweeted and then deleted a photo of a black DC worker eating on a train, which is against Metro policy. Many on social media perceive Tynes' accusation unwarranted tattletale attack on a person of color. It's very strange, right? So it's not allowed in a train. I take a picture of somebody doing it, all of a sudden I'm a racist. It's like, wow, so bizarre. That statement paved the way for widespread media attention and ruined Tynes' reputation. And again, I'm saying this as a black person. I'd much rather, it's great that people out there are trying, vigilant and aware and kind of keeping an eye out for any kind of racial bias or attacks on minorities or whatever it may be. Kudos to you guys. Like, thank you. That's awesome. You're taking some work off our back. But I would much rather the attention be given to actual issues, like real life issues, issues that are actually affecting people's lives, people's families, that are going to impact the community. Because this is just nonsense, isn't it? Really? Absolute nonsense. The worker knew she was in the wrong. The community knew she was in the wrong. Like, everyone knows that what the wrong is in this situation. The person tweets it. Okay, cool. Maybe don't, what's that word called? Invade someone's privacy in that regard. It might be some privacy laws or taking people's picture working, who are working on the trains. Fair enough there. But to say it's some kind of level of racism or work shaming is bizarre, right? It's similar to that girl that took a picture of the dude from The Cosby Show bagging up groceries, right? It was like, was that real work shaming, or was that you just saying, oh, wow, shit, that guy who I just watched the other day on TV is now bagging my groceries? Like, it's just, I don't know, it's not nice. It's not something I would do. It's not something that's very classy. But again, if you're a kid and you take pictures of everything that you do, from your shits to your sandwiches, I'm not surprised you take a picture of somebody bagging your groceries. But this is like a nonsense story. And now look who's being damaged. The actual publisher's being famed for them standing up. So it's going to cost them $30 million or around about, because they're probably going to settle outside of court, for being socially aware, right? For fighting the social justice warrior fight. And if they just would have taken a breath, took a step back and analyzed it properly, and came to a maybe a more of a decent resolution, it would have been fine. It's just a crazy situation. Times lawsuit outlines her position that Rare Bird, an all-white company, inaccurately painted her, an immigrant woman of color, as racist. It's so weird. An all-white company paints a Jordanian American as racist. It's crazy. Eisen says Times has simply suffered consequences of her tweet. It is ironic that having taken advantage of the First Amendment rights with an ill-advised tweet, Ms. Times now seeks to stifle and punish us. Use of those very same rights of respected book publisher who legitimately expressed their opinion of the conduct rather than take responsibility for her own actions. Yeah, that might be some level of it, but you don't drop someone because they tweeted a picture of somebody eating a sandwich. That's ridiculous. But yeah, so crazy situation, and again shows to me that there needs to be a revision of cancel culture. I don't think there will be, because it seems like a bit of a sport nowadays, you know, to rile people up, get people's attention. But yeah, this needs to end, because it's gonna, again, needs to end more so on the side of the employees and the employers, because it's gonna cost them an arm and a leg, right? Because some people are just gonna fight back. They're gonna weather the storm on social. They're gonna get the barrages of insults. Call me what you want to call me. Send me death threats. Blah blah blah. And then they're gonna come back and attack. That's what everyone's gonna do. I think so. In these kind of situations, again, whether or not you can handle the onslaught, because I'm sure it must be weird being a regular person all of a sudden having thousands of people attack you over something that you didn't think was a bad thing anyway in the first place, must be such a mindfuck. But it's gonna start costing these companies bucks, because people are not having it anymore. It's like, she's not having it. Right, she had a panic attack, she moved out of the country, but she's like, look, enough's enough. Why are you dropping me for? Yeah, I did a little bit of a social oopsie, but is that enough to drop me and cancel my entire career because of a tweet? Like, even if it was something that was done maliciously, is it enough to cancel her whole career? That's the question you have to ask yourself. And I don't think it is. It might be worth a slap on the wrist, it might be worth some pointing fingers off, it might be worth people boycotting her next release and she's not getting the books. Okay, cool, but canceling my whole career? It goes back to Jeremy Piven thing. Super, super strange. But anyway, I'll keep my eye on this one because it's very, very interesting. But yeah, Natasha Tynes suing her publisher because she took a picture of somebody eating a sandwich. Mamma mia. Stuff goes from 0 to 100, isn't it? It's fucking interesting.